بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Someone asked, I live with people and some of them they make my life miserable. How can I be happy? الحمد لله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy. So, inshallah, let's begin by analyzing the beginning portion of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he starts his book with the Fatiha, you know, seeking for guidance and all these things. And then he starts Surah Al-Baqarah. And what's interesting is, in the beginning portion of Baqarah, he introduces the Qur'an, and right after that, he starts distinguishing humanity into different categories. And so he says, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This is the book, there's no doubt about it. It's a source of guidance for the people of taqwa. So he describes the people of taqwa, the people that have iman, they believe in Allah, they believe in the Messenger, they believe in the end of time, they believe in the Day of Judgment, they believe in what was revealed to it, the Prophet, and what was revealed before the Prophet. And then Allah gives a very concise description of the people of iman, the muttaqin. And then he talks about the disbelieving people that are openly disbelievers, and they're set in their ways. And whether you warn them, you don't warn them, they're not willing to change. And then he talks about hypocrites, people that fall under munafiqun, and how their mentality is and the complexities of their personality. When they're with the believers, they say, we believe. When they're with the disbelievers, they say, we're with you actually, we're just joking around. So why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begin his book and start talking to us about people? This is very interesting to think about. Our ulama, they said the reason is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make it clear and make it known that, oh humanity, you're not all the same. There is different people. And people are different in their personalities, in their character traits, in their spirituality, and their aims, and their goals, and their motives. So don't be naive, but also at the same time, don't be surprised. Don't be surprised when you see anything from the people. This is an expected thing when you're living with the people. So that being said, we as believers, how do we deal with this? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us, don't be like those that have no free will, right? When somebody does good to them, they respond with good. When somebody does bad to them, they respond with bad. The people are determining their reaction, right? But he said, you should rather be those that does good, whether someone does good to you or bad to you, it doesn't matter. You have your own personality, you have your own aim, you have your own goal. And when you do things, we're not doing anything for the people. When you do any kindness to them, our goal, our aim, there's nothing personal between us and the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he teaches us in Surah Al-Insan that the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they feed and they do anything that's considered good work, they say, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. We only feed you for the sake of Allah, seeking Allah's face. And we don't ask you for any kind of reward or any kind of gratitude. Right, so it's important to set your expectations, because if you set your expectations and you're expecting something from the people, you're setting yourself up for disappointment. And I gotta tell you, disappointment, it's actually a planned activity. Like, we plan to be disappointed. How? For example, husband and wife married. The wife says to herself, thinking inside, I'm gonna be disappointed in just about half an hour. And then half an hour passes, and then suddenly now she's like, okay, now I'm disappointed. Husband says, what's going on? I'm so disappointed in you. Why? You forgot what day it is. Right? She planned to be disappointed. So she actually, because she set up an expectation, and now she has this internal system at work. So she brought this feeling up at a planned time. So whatever feelings we have about the people, you're the one doing it. It's you. Right? So how do we deal with this? Remove the people from the equation. You're dealing with Allah. How are you dealing with Allah? Allah put them in your life. He says, وَجَعَلْنَا بَعْدُكُمْ لِبَعْدٍ فِتْنَةً وَتَصْبِرُوا. Some of you made fitna for its others. Are you going to be patient? Right. So now, it's not you're dealing with your cousin or your wife or your husband, your nephew, your father, your mother. Now, the equation is different now. You're dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is bringing you kindness from the people, and Allah is bringing you trials and tribulations from the people. How are you going to bear with this? Are you going to have patience? Are you going to flip out and have problems with Allah? May Allah protect us, right? We don't want no problems with Allah. We love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. or you know, to the capacity Allah has created love in us. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that's why he taught us to have husnul dhan. Think good of people. Don't accuse, make excuses for them. One of the ulama, they said, if you smell alcohol in the beard of your brother, then say someone must have spilled it there. Like, don't go to the negative. Always think good of the people, and also speak good of the people. The Prophet ﷺ said, when you speak of your brother, speak good or stay silent, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, do you love to eat the dead flesh of your brother? You would hate it. So don't speak ill of each other. So our deen is a deen that reorients us with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We take our mind and attention away from everyone, and we focus on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our ulama, they made this map for us. How do you know that you're progressing in your spirituality and your deen? They said the first stage, you're a wanderer. You're someone who's wandering through life. And how do you know you're in that state? You're always concerned about other people. You're always concerned about other people. And a lot of people, they misunderstand the ayah. For example, Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Oh, you people of Iman, save yourself and your family from the fire. Right? So they say, it's my job. I have to be hard on my family, and I have to do this, and I have to do that. And they become this overbearing personality over their families. Whereas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made their families their circumstance. This is your circumstance. And he says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيْرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيْرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah will not change your circumstance until you change what's in yourself. So Allah didn't ask you to guide your family. He asked you to save your family from the hellfire. How do you save them from the hellfire? By being the best husband, best father, best mother, best sister, best whatever you are, whatever role you're playing, by being the best in that role towards them and having compassion, right? Because Allah says in the Quran, don't get this twisted. He says, you will never guide the ones you love. It's not your job. لَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. But Allah, He guides whoever He wants. So it's not your job to change people. So stop being concerned about the people. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, right? Change yourself, and by you becoming better, an example for them, you're going to save them from the fire. And so the first stage where you're a wanderer, you're always concerned about the people, and they're never pleased with you. They're never happy with you. If you please one person, someone else is displeased with you. And so this is a cycle you can get stuck in for the rest of your life, and it's painful and it's miserable, and you'll never find happiness in that state. So the first stage is that you're a wanderer and you're just a ping pong between the people. And then the second stage, you start becoming a seeker. You start delving into yourself. And so, you know, you become busy with yourself and not the people. When you start focusing on yourself, And taking care of your faults, your flaws in character, you start working on yourself, and you're not concerned so much about what the people think, you're now on your way. Alhamdulillah. You're now on your way because now you're focusing on yourself. And the purification of the self, this is where it starts, right? You're purifying yourself. And a best way to get into this is learn the fact that people are different. Everybody's different. So don't become overworked by the differences in the people. Focus on yourself. If you find, for example, somebody, it comes easy for them to get up and read Quran, but you, it comes difficult, don't say, why that person, they can do this and not me. There is no comparison. Every single person is unique. Even the twins that are born of the same womb, they have their own unique personalities. They have their own unique traits. So it's not for us to compare and contrast. And all this. No, focus on yourself. If you see anything good in you, then alhamdulillah. If you see anything wrong in you, if you see anything wrong in others, consider that's in you, because they're your mirror now. If you see any flaw in them, if you see anything that you dislike in others, then notice that, whoa, I just felt something bad in myself about this person, right? So it's not a flaw in them, it's a flaw in you. So start working on yourself until you see nothing except good in others, right? Until you see nothing except good in others. And if they do anything, it's from Allah. Don't be surprised. It's a test. Allah said we created people differently. So you focus on yourself. This is the second stage. You're a seeker. And then I said, you know, the stage after that, you start busying yourself with your Lord and not yourself. So first stage, you start busying yourself and not others. Busying yourself with yourself and not others. Second stage, you start busying yourself with Allah and not yourself. Because you focus on yourself enough and you find out, you know, I try to change myself, I have this, I have that, and I struggle against myself for so long, it's very difficult and it's very tiring, it's everything. So now let me focus on Allah's mercy. And you start focusing on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You start focusing on His attributes, on His qualities. And as you draw closer, you find those qualities, they start appearing in you. The quality of mercy, the quality of patience, the quality of forbearance, all that stuff. Because now you're drinking from the ocean. La ilaha illallah. So, alhamdulillah, I don't want this video to get too long, but inshallah we can continue talking about these subjects. But I hope that answers the question, if you're living with people that are making your life miserable, how can you be happy? Be patient with Allah. Be patient with Allah. Allah put them in your life. And don't try to change them. Change yourself. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.